you know, it's an emotional day. You know, there's been tears shed, you know, between parents and kids and trainers, and it's a very emotional day. And it's a very exciting day for our organization, exciting day for our farm system, exciting day for our city. So, you know, it's been great so far. I think the three guys today, you know, I think you're looking at, you know, a power horse starter in Susanna, who's got a chance to be an elite type of arm. Then you look at Verdugo and Rojas, two very polished bats for their age group. And, you know, we think all three have a chance to be plus, you know, plus makeup and plus talent.
Yeah, we'd seen them fairly early in the process, tried to circle back a number of times. At one point, looked like he was off the market, and then, you know, some things happened and all of a sudden he was back on the market, and it worked out that that I was there, and me and Alvin were in to see him, and came out, you know, throwing smoke and getting after it, and saw him up to 94, 96, flashing very good breaking ball and some feel for a changeup, a hard sink on a changeup, and we, you know, it was kind of eye popping, and we felt like we had to do something, so we moved on it, and we're very happy that we got him. Well, I think we formed a very good relationship. We have a very good relationship with Isabel Medina, and we got around him as best we could. We took some ownership and some partnership in his development, and stayed close and kind of helped him along the way, and stayed with him as best we could. And I think he felt like it was family here in San Diego, and he chose us.
Yeah, it's a bat-first guy that's very versatile. There's a chance for five tools. He can steal bases. He can play all over the dirt. He'd even play center field if you need him to. But the one thing that stood out was just his quality of game at bats. You know, he's going to take his walk. He's going to swing his strikes. And we like the consistency of his at-bats. You know, Verdugo can play second, short, and third. He's always played with older guys in Mexico. You know, hit 350 this winter, playing in some winter ball for the Diablos. So, you know, very polished bat, and excited to get him and Yindri together in our DSL lineup. And I would expect them to be hitting in the middle of the order. Yeah, I think it's going to be a versatile class. You know, we like to stay up the middle. You know, there's going to be a lot of shortstops that can play all over the place. We've got a few center fielders and, you know, hopefully a handful of pitchers that we reject as starters. You know, we want to stay up the middle of the diamond and develop them as best we can. I think you're always just conscious of wherever you go. And you try and do the best you can to stay as safe as you can. You know, we're always getting tested and making sure our complex is in a good spot and everything's staying clean. And we're just trying to be as safe as we can. It's definitely tough everywhere in the world right now. So we do the best as we can, like anyone else, and just trying to stay safe. A lot of our work's done at the field. You know, we watch how guys interact, how they practice, how they play games. You know, we can still, you know, talk to resources, talk to references, talk to coaches, and watch the kids play. And that's going to determine a lot of their makeup. So I think it's still been pretty normal from that aspect, but still just trying to stay as safe as possible.
Yeah, I think excited to bring Jose back. And I think everybody's seen him, you know, knows like what his ability is when he's healthy. And I think that's just the biggest key. He's had a good off season, and, you know, I think looking forward to seeing him come to camp, be ready to throw and be ready to compete. And, you know, I think it's been a couple of years now. So I think from his standpoint, he's super excited to be back in the fold. And, you know, I think we're looking forward to seeing him back on the mound. And so far, he's had a really good offseason from a health standpoint. He's had two things. He had, you know, obviously arm stuff, and he's had some back stuff, you know, over the course of the last year. He's always had, you know, some of the back issues. So I think just kind of getting both of those in a good spot. And he's had, you know, the last, you know, 4 or 5 months being in the complex in Arizona, he's done a good job with it. So I think for right now, he looks like he's on schedule and ready to go. No, I think we're preparing. I mean, like, you know, we try to, again, I think it's kind of, you know, like, you know, different scenario. Like obviously last year's with COVID, and we haven't, you know, at least our group hasn't gone through this, you know, this lockout type deal. So I think we're just looking at different scenarios, wanting to be prepared. Kind of meeting with the big league staff. So hopefully when there is an agreement, we're ready to hit the ground running. And again, there's, you know, I think from a scouting standpoint, it's all systems go, you know, I mean, I think, you know, I think from that standpoint, amateur scouting, obviously we're super excited today with the international period. Our group's you know, they work really hard, and this is a culmination of like years in the making process, signing the class. And, you know, we put a lot of emphasis on the development side. So those things we've been able to really, really put a lot of attention on the last couple of months. And then from the big league standpoint, it's just being prepared. And, you know, when there is agreement, when there is that point in time, we'll be ready to get back to baseball at the big league level.
Do plans go forward with minor league spring training, regardless of what happens with those negotiations?
That's what we're looking at right now. I mean, again, I think we're going to be open to hearing what comes from the league and how it is. But I think, you know, so far, I think for us, it's get ready for minor league camp, you know, as is. We haven't heard anything different. And that's how we're planning things.